Hello, my name is Todd Infinger RN, and I'm going to show you my ID. And today I'm going to be performing a complete physical examination and health assessment. My patient is from here on out going to be identified by the initial J. J, do you give verbal consent to me recording this video, and do you also give consent to my instructor reviewing this video?
I do.
You do. Very good. All right. Before I started recording this, I got a health history on Jay. He's here today to get a physical prior to entering nursing school. He has no complaints, and he states he has no health issues, either chronic or acute. He states he has no drug or food allergies whatsoever. I obtained a family history from him in which he stated that there are no chronic issues in his on either his maternal or paternal side of his family. He states that he received all his vaccinations as an infant, and has paperwork showing that he has recently had to reduce some vaccinations related to him entering nursing school. One item of note is he has had his wisdom teeth removed, and he also has had a tonsillectomy at age 5. He takes no medications at all, and I was able to obtain his vital signs, in which I got a temperature of 98.2, a pulse of 80, a blood pressure of 126 over 84, an O2 saturation of 99%, and his respirations are at 16. All right. So now we're going to begin the examination, and I'm going to pretend that I'm just entering the room.
All right.
And I'm going to knock.
Come in.
Hi there, Jay. My name is Todd. I'm going to be performing a health assessment on you today. How are you?
I'm well.
Very well. All right. And before we begin, I'm just going to wash my hands thoroughly. And I am going to place some examination gloves on. Very good. All right. The first thing I noticed about Jay is that he is well groomed. He appears to be his stated age, which is 27 years old. He appears to be 27 years old. Jason, where are you right now?
I'm in Pace, Florida.
Pace, Florida. And who's the president?
President Donald Trump.
President Donald Trump. And where are you right now?
I am at home.
And what city?
Oh, Pace, Florida.
You're in Pace, Florida. Very good. Okay, so he is alert and oriented times 3. He attends to questions and answers my questions appropriately. His skin color is uniformly pigmented, pink, intact, free of lesions, and his nutritional status is within normal limits for his height and build, and his body fat appears to be evenly distributed. His posture, when we were interviewing earlier, he stands comfortably, he stands erect with arms relaxed at his sides. He has no physical deformities. He ambulates with a normal gait and station. He uses no assisted devices, full range of motion, and I have not detected any involuntary movements. His facial expressions, he maintains eye contact with me appropriately. He has a comfortable mood and a pleasant affect. His speech is clear, His content is appropriate. His native language is English. And his hearing appears to be good. He is not obviously lip reading or favoring one ear to the other. His personal hygiene, he's clean, he's groomed, his hair is brushed, everything looks good and normal there. Culturally, he is an American from the panhandle of Florida. So we will have a similar culture. His weight is 250 pounds. His height is 6'4". Moving on. And the first thing I'm gonna do with Jay is I'm gonna do a vision test on you, Jay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have you hold this. We're gonna do it on both eyes. If you hold that, I am going to simulate, I don't have enough space to move 20 feet away from the patient, so I'm gonna pretend that I'm moving 20 feet away from the patient and use a Snellen chart to assess his visual acuity. So I'm moving away from the patient. We're going to say this is 20 feet. Jay, if you'll cover one eye. And go ahead and read for me the lowest row on this Snellen chart that you can.
B-E-F-P-O-T-E-C.
Very good. All right. Go ahead and cover the other eye.
B-E-F-P-O-T-E-C.
Very good. Okay, so I've assessed, I'll take this from you, and I've assessed Jay's visual acuity at 20/20. All right, so that's good and normal. All right, and then I'm going to assess now your radial pulses. So I'm just, let me make sure I can see. All right, if I can just hold your wrists. Very good, his radial pulses are palpable and even and bilateral. We're going to assume that I am doing this for 1 minute and I'm getting a pulse of 80 beats per minute. All right, his respirations are 16 a minute. They're unlabored, even, and no shortness of breath is noticed. All right, and I obtained his blood pressure earlier, I'll restate. I got it from his left arm while he was sitting, and I got a 126 over 84, which is within normal limits. Jay, do you have any pain today?
No, I do not.
No pain. If he had reported pain to me, I would have asked him for a scale, on a scale of 1 to 10, and to describe the pain, where it was, point to the pain, where he's hurting. He's reporting none whatsoever. Otherwise, I would have asked him all those questions on a scale of 1 to 10. No pain, that's good. All right, so first I'm going to start with the his hands. So I'm going to make sure that you can see me, yes? All right, and I'm just going to have your hands. I'm going to look at your nails, all right? And I can see no pitting or clubbing in the fingernails. Cap refill is less than 3 seconds. That's all within normal limits. No lesions on the skin. The skin is warm, dry, no discoloration. He's evenly pigmented throughout. His skin is pink. His temperature is warm. Again, he's dry. Texture is smooth. And I'm gonna just assess the skin turgor. There's a little pinch. And it's elastic, normal, good skin turgor. All right, very good. Again, no lesions noted anywhere. All right, now I'm gonna start with the top of you, Jay, and move all the way down, okay? All right, first I'm gonna start with the scalp, hair, and cranium, and I'm just gonna palpate. I feel no lumps. I see no lesions, no parasites, which normally live back here. And everything about the scalp looks within normal limits. All right, and what I'm going to do is now, Jay, is I'm going to assess your cranial nerve 7. So what I want you to do for me is give me a big smile, big as you can. Very good. All right. So the smile is symmetrical and equal. No weakness noted on either side. So no weakness unilaterally whatsoever. So that's good. Okay. So now I'm going to assess the temporal artery. Just going to make sure you can see me. I'm right at the temples. The temporal arteries are palpable and bilaterally equal. And now I'm going to assess the temporomandibular joint. So I'm going to press. Hopefully you can see what I'm doing. And Jay, if you will open and close your mouth a few times for me. Very good. No crepitus noted here, no clicking or clacking, everything is within normal limits there. All right, let's see. All right, now I'm just going to palpate his sinuses, starting with the maxillary. And let me know if you have any tenderness here, okay?
No.
Nothing there. Very good. And the frontal?
No.
All good there. Okay, very good. No pain or tinnitus noted there. The eyebrows, eyelashes are all well-groomed, clean, free of crusting or anything of that nature. Everything there within normal limits. All right. Now, what I'm going to do now is check your visual fields, which would be cranial nerve 2. So I'm going to let you have this back and cover one eye. All right, and what I'm checking for confrontation. Very good. And going to this side. Very nice. Okay. So in that, cranial nerve 2 must be intact. Visual fields are full. And next, I'm going to check the extraocular muscles and corneal light reflex. So I'm just going to point my pen light in the center, and everything looks within normal limits there. Very good. All right. That. Next, we're going to check the cardinal positions of gaze. So again, with the pen light, we're going to, this also tests cranial nerve 3, 4, and 6. All right. And what I'm going to do is keep your head still and follow the pen light. Okay. Can you see it up here?
Mm-hmm.
Can you see the pen light? Look at it. There you go. Just follow it. All right. Very good. So those cranial nerves appear to be intact. Everything there within normal limits. Very good. That. All right. And next we're going to, I'm going to have a look at your conjunctiva. So I'm just going to place my hands. Here, I'll take that so you don't have to hold it. Make sure that we can be seen. And I'm just going to open here. Conjunctiva are clear, sclera is white, corneas are well-defined, irises are blue, round, and regular. All right, now we're going to go back to the pupils. Get my pen light again. All right, and I'm going to say that I'm darkening the room. I won't be able to do that because we're recording this, but let's assume I've darkened the room at this point. And I'm going to, all right, so we're going to just look at the pupil reflex. Both pupils are reacting as they should, and I am going to check your accommodation. I'm just going to hold the pin light up, have a look at the front of the pin light, then look back at the wall. Very good. So the accommodation is within normal limits. And the pupil shape is about 3 millimeters normal under these light conditions. And one more thing is I'm going to check, all right, if you'll just look straight ahead, begin with the pin light. And the right cornea reacts when I shine the light through. So we have Perla here, which is within normal limits. Very, very good. All right. Now I don't have an ophthalmoscope, so I'm going to simulate one with, again, my pin light. All right, and Jay, if you will just look straight at the wall, back at the wall, and I'm going to have a look in your eyes, and I can see here the disc is circular with a pale center. Clear margins, clearly defined margins, and the vessels are clearly defined. The retinal backgrounds, I don't see any hemorrhaging and no pale patches. Good. Very, very, very good. Okay, now we're going to move to the ears, and I'm going to start with the external ears. And I can see that the let me just look straight ahead. And they're equal bilaterally. The skin here, again, is intact, warm, dry, free of lesions. And no exudate noted from either ear. Very good. So that's within normal limits. And I'm going to just check now for any tenderness. Any pain?
No.
When I press no? Okay, good. So no tenderness there. All right, so what I'm going to do again, I don't have an otoscope, so I'm going to simulate it with my pin light once again. All right, and I'm just going to have a look inside the ear canals with my otoscope. And I see that and I'm pulling up and back as you do with an adult. And the canal is clear, no excessive cerumen. The tympanic membrane is pearly gray and intact. All right, and that looks good. I'm gonna repeat the process on the other side. Again, up and back. Ear canal is clear with no excessive cerumen. The tympanic membrane is pearly gray and intact. Very good. All right, so now we're going to test cranial nerve 8 using a voice test. So Jay, what I'm going to have you do is close one ear with your hand, the other one I'm on the side. So go ahead and close that ear, and I'm going to whisper a word to you, and I'd like you to repeat it for me out loud.
Rosie.
Very good. And let's do it on the other side.
Dog park.
Very good. Okay. So that would tell us that cranial nerve 8 is intact, and he's hearing the whispering bilaterally. Now we're going to do a Weber test. I don't have a tuning fork, so I'm just going to use my pen to simulate. So what we're going to do is, Jay, I'm going to make this thing vibrate. I'm going to place it on your head. Let me know if you can hear it in both ears, and then tell me when it stops, okay? All right. Bong.
Can I hear it?
Tell me when it stops.
Stopped.
Very good. Okay. So, heard equally on the Weber test, so we're good there. And again, I'm going to now do the Rene test. So again, I'm using the tuning fork, and again, the same thing. I'm going to tell me when you hear it and when it stops, okay? Bong.
I hear it. Stop.
Very good. And we'll do that on the other side. Bong.
I hear it.
And it stopped. Very good. So, good on the Rene test again, within normal limits. That's telling us that he has good bone and ear conduction and it's efficient. All right, now we're gonna go to the nose and I'm gonna examine the nose. I can see, make sure you can see me. I can see that the nose is symmetrical. The skin is intact again, warm and dry. No exudate is noted. And no tenderness, correct? No tenderness in the nose? Very good. Great. All right. And I can see that both nostrils are patent. The nares are patent. Any sensitivity when I do that?
No.
Very good. All right. I don't have an otoscope, so I'm going to use my pen light again for the otoscope. And we're going to this time have a speculum on the end of the otoscope, and I'm gonna have a look inside his nostrils. All right, so if you'll just tilt your head back just slightly, and again, otoscope here with the speculum, and I'm just gonna go in and look, and I can see that the nasal mucosa is clear, pink, and moist, no lesions noted. The septum is normal and medial, and the turbinates are projected, and but also leaving ample room for breathing. So that's good, and within normal limits. Also, the turbinates are a lightish red color. Very good. All right. Next, we're gonna move to the mouth and throat. The lips are pink, moist, no cracking is noted, no lesions. And if I can just see your teeth, teeth and gums, I see no lesions. The gums are look very healthy. Again, this patient is missing his wisdom teeth only. All other teeth are intact. Let me see your tongue. Tongue is symmetrical. Protrudes down the midline, and I'm just going to don't have a tongue depressor, so again we're going to simulate that, and I'm just going to have a look in, and I can see that the hard and soft palates are moist and pink, and I see no lesions on anything. Again, this patient has no tonsils. The uvula is intact and present. And again, I'm going to test for cranial nerves 9 and 10 with the gag reflex. So, let's look at it. Okay, so he gagged, and we know that that tells us, is a good indicator that cranial nerves 9 and 10 are intact. Okay. And if you'll go ahead and just stick your tongue out one more time for me. Great, so we're looking at cranial nerve 12 here, which that's a good indicator that that is intact. No problem there. All right, and now we're gonna move to the neck. All right, so just having a quick look, I can see that the neck is symmetrical. There are no lumps or pulsations. We're gonna go ahead and check your cervical lymph nodes. And you'll let me know if there's any tenderness here. Any tenderness there?
No.
Right. Submandibular. Any tenderness here?
No.
Okay. So I've assessed the cervical lymph nodes, the submandibular lymph nodes. I don't feel them. That's a normal finding. They're non-palpable. All right. Very good. And I'm just going to check the carotid pulse one at a time so he doesn't pass out. All right. Very good. So the carotid pulse is palpable. I would say 2+, which is a normal finding, and bilaterally. The trachea is at the midline. All right, and so we're just going to, again, look at another cranial nerve, 11. So if you wouldn't mind, give me a yes and a no. Do a whole way around. Very good, and shrug your shoulders up. Very good. So that's showing us that cranial nerve 11 is intact, and I see no weakness, full range of motion there. All right, so if, Jay, if you'll just turn a little bit this way so I can get behind you and make sure that we can see. Very good, or that's even better. All right, and all right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hand you this water, and I'm just gonna feel of your thyroid gland while I palpate. Okay, go ahead. Very nice. Okay. And I'll just set that back down. All right, so the thyroid gland is non-tender, correct?
Right.
And non-palpable, I still need your back. All right, so now we're going to the chest, lungs, and posterior. Posterior and lateral. All right, and I can visually see, without palpating, I'm visually seeing that the thoracic cage is symmetrical and elliptical in shape. It's intact. The skin again is pink in color, free of lesions, warm and dry. The symmetry, the thorax is symmetrical, and the scapulae are also symmetrical here. Very good. All right. And if you'll just take a deep breath for me. All right, fantastic. I can see that the chest expand, the symmetrical the expansion is symmetrical posteriorly. And what I want you to do is now I'm gonna just very lightly place my hand here, and I'm gonna ask you to say 99. 99, very good. So I can feel slight vibration there, no tactile phrenitis, and any lumps or tenderness through your back? Yes,
no,
very good. All right, now just note that. Okay, so now I'm just going to assess your spinal process. So I'm just placing two fingers down. I can feel the C7 here. Very good. The spinal processes are intact, straight, and not tender. All right, and I'm gonna percuss over the lung fields. Okay, and I'm hearing a clear, dull thumping sound, which is within normal limits, okay? So what we're gonna do now is I'm going to have you take a deep breath. Hold it. Good, all right. So during inhalation, I'm not gonna draw on him. And also we're assuming that this patient has his shirt off. I'm going to draw a line here to denote the lung field during inhalation, and now exhale. And hold it. Okay, and I can now draw a line here, and I'm going to say that's about a 2 centimeter difference, which is also within normal limits. Okay, all right. All right. No tenderness. Okay, and now I'm just going to listen to his breath sounds. So just breathe normally for me, Jay. Very good. So I'm getting clear to auscultation bilaterally, and I hear no adventitious sounds. Very good. All right. Now you can just stay. Actually, if you'll just swing out to be exactly where we were when we started, I'm going to move to the front of the patient. All right. And again, I'm going to tell you that the skin, this is, we're assuming that the patient is bare-chested. The skin is warm, dry, free of lesions. It looks very healthy, smooth. Okay. All right, and again, we're going to assess for tactile phimitis anteriorly. So we're going to do 99 again. Say it.
99.
Very good. Again.
99.
And one more time.
99.
Very good. Okay, so no vibrations, no lumps, no tenderness that he's mentioning. And I'm going to percuss the lung fields. It's much easier to hear on the front. And I'm getting a dull sound bilaterally, which is what we expect. Very good. And again, just breathe normally, and I'm going to assess your breath sounds. Very good. Both bilaterally, once again, clear, no wheezing, no ronchi, no adventitious sounds whatsoever within normal limits. All right, so now we're going to assess your upper extremities. So what we're going to do is have you put your hands straight out, up, down, flex and extend. And now I'm going to just apply gentle pressure. Go ahead, fight me. And the other way. Very good. Okay. And then we're going to do, I'm assessing the range of motion of your shoulders. Go ahead and give me one of these. Very good. Can you wiggle around a little? Very good. Okay. Full range of motion there. And Let me put your hands back out if you wouldn't mind, please. Straight out. All right, press down, press up. Very good. Okay, so strength is good. There's no weakness noted. And I'm just going to feel for your epitrochocular nodes on the left and on the right. They're not palpable, which is normal. All right. And we are going to show the next spot. Very good. All right. And next we're going to just, I'm just going to, all right. So actually what I'm going to do is have you lay down, please. Patient to be supine. And I'll be on the patient's right. Let me just put this under your head so you're more comfortable. Very good. All right, and although this is a male, I'm going to palpate the breasts. No lumps or lesions noted bilaterally. And I'm going to palpate the axillae and the regional nodes. Okay. Any tenderness here?
No.
Very good. Let's try the other. Any tenderness?
No.
Very good. So no tenderness. Again, they're not palpable, which the regional nodes are not palpable when at normal limits. Very good. All right, so at this point, I'm going to inspect the jugular veins. I can see that they are intact on both sides. I see no distension, no pulsations. They're present when they're supine, and I'm gonna lift, they're present when the patient is supine, and I'm just gonna like pretend to lift you up 30 degrees, and they are not present at this point. Okay, relax. Very good. All right. Now we're gonna move to the heart. I'm gonna look at the precordium, and I don't see any pulsations or heaving here. The apical pulse, apical impulse, is here on the in the fifth left intercostal space. There's no thrill. All right. And I feel no palpable vibrations, no thrills here. All right. And I'm going now to get the apical rate and rhythm again. I'm going to the fifth left intercostal space on this patient. Oh, I'm going to just clean my stuff with an alcohol swab. Feeling down, I'm in the fifth left intercostal space, and I'm going to listen to this for 1 minute. Let's assume 1 minute has passed, and I'm getting a pulse rate, an apical pulse rate of 77. Very good. All within normal limits. Very good. The rhythm was normal. Normal rate and rhythm. All right, and then I'm going to now listen to the heart sounds. I'm going to state that I'm going to use the bell of the stethoscope to listen for extra heart sounds, and you'll see me do that. I'm going to do that now, and I'm going to start, go from the apex to the base in a Z pattern. Very good. S1, S2, normal, not diminished. No extra sounds, no murmurs. Very good. And Jay, I'm gonna have you move, roll onto your left side, and I'm gonna do the same process again. Very good. All right. And once again, I've got normal sounds, no extra heart sounds or murmurs. Very, very good. Okay. So now we're going to look at the abdomen. Symmetrical, No masses are visible. Very good. Again, the skin is warm and dry and free of lesions. We're again assuming this patient is bare-chested. All right, warm, dry, again, free of lesions on the skin. All right, the umbilicus is medial, and I do not see any pulsations. All right, and I'm just going to auscultate for bowel sounds. Very nice. All right, so the bowel sounds are present. I wouldn't say hyperactive or hypoactive. I would call them normal. All right, and I'm also going to listen to the aorta, renal, iliac, and femoral vascular sounds. Put your hands to yours. There we go. Good. Check and see. Yes. And femoral. 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 Present. Okay. So no brewery anywhere there. So we're no brewery over the aorta, most importantly, probably. Okay. Now I'm going to percuss around the abdomen and let's see what we've got there. And I'm noting tympani sounds around the umbilicus. Dull sounds around the flanks. Okay. And now I'm going to palpate to see if I can locate the liver. From my palpations, I'm going to guess that we've got about a 10.5 centimeter long liver. Dull sounds is how I was using to distinguish that. And I'm going to do the same thing for the spleen. There it is. Okay, so I'm going to now palpate the patient's abdomen. And let me know if you have any pain, okay? No pain?
No pain.
Using both light and deep palpations here. The muscles are relaxed. And he's reporting no pain. I feel no masses or enlargement of any of the organs. All right. Okay. Now, I've done the femoral pulse. That was regular, I'd say 2+, which is a normal finding. And the inguinal nodes, assuming this, again, is exposed to skin. Any pain or tenderness here?
No.
Very good. All right. Non-palpable, again, within normal limits. Okay. Now I'm just going to assess his lower extremities. Hopefully you can see me. Back up. All right. So I can see that the legs are symmetrical. Again, the skin is warm, dry, and free of lesions with a pink color, and the pigmentation is even. There's a light hair distribution bilaterally. And I'm going to check your pulses now. So if you could just lift one leg up. Checking for the popliteal pulse, it is intact. Regular rate and rhythm, I would say 2+ within normal limits once again. Great. And let's just have a look at the other. Very good. Probably hard to see this. I am behind the knee, basically. All right. Present and equal, regular rate and rhythm, 2+. Again, bilaterally, so they're equal bilaterally, and I'm just gonna lay back out. And I'm going to feel, I can do these both at the same time. I'm gonna feel them both, the posterior tibial pulses. Here they are. They are regular rate and rhythm. I'd say 2+ again, equal bilaterally. Again, normal finding. And dorsalis pedis, I am at the top of the feet. I probably can't see this, but I'm on top of the foot and I find it here. In here, regular rate and rhythm, again 2+ a normal finding. I don't see any edema, no bruising, no swelling, no edema. Again, the skin is warm without being too warm. And I'm just going to separate the toes here. I see no lesions. Again, the capillary refill is less than 3 seconds. Skin is warm, dry, again, no lesions, even pigmentation. All right, before I have you sit up, I'm going to check, I'm going to kind of move ahead since he's already laying down and reduce the amount of times we move him around. I'm going to check your cerebral function by having you place your toes on your knee and move them down your shin. All the way down. There we go. All right, can you do the other side? All right, very, very good. All right, and then while you're down, let me have you lift one leg up and then the other. Very good. All right, do that again and let me give you some. Very good. Okay, no weakness noted here. One more. There we go. Push against me. Very, very good. No crepitus noticed, full range of motion there. Okay, and now if you'll bring one knee up and then the other. There you go. Very good. All right, put him back down. Now I'm going to put some resistance on you. Go ahead. Very good. No weakness. And the other. Very good. Okay. No crepitus there as well. Very nice. Okay. Now I'm going to have you sit up and face again where we started. All right. So now we're going to test for neurologic function. I'm going to use three devices. I'm going to use this to test dull and sharp, and this piece of cotton to test the sensation. And we're going to do that on the face, on the arms, hands, legs, and feet. So, Jay, I'm going to show you while your eyes are open what the difference. Okay, so there's dull and there's sharp. You feel that? Mm-hmm. Okay. So if you just go ahead and close your eyes, I'm going to start on the face.
Dull.
Good.
Dull. Sharp.
Sharp. Good.
Dull. Sharp.
Very good. All right, let's move to the arms.
Sharp. Sharp. Dull. Sharp. Sharp. Dull.
Dull.
Sharp.
Okay. Hands.
Sharp. Dull.
Good.
Sharp.
Okay. While we're up here, let's just test the sensation with the cotton. Let me know if you can feel me.
Yes. 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 Uh-huh. Yes.
Very nice. Let's do the legs.
Sharp. 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 Dull. Dull.
Good.
Sharp. 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 Dull.
Good. All right, and one more thing. Keep your eyes closed. Let's just test the sensations.
Yes.
Neurologic assessment there is positive all along the face, arms, hands, legs, and feet. All right. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is test the patient's position sense. I'm going to, Jay, I'm going to take your hand, keep your eyes closed. All right, and I'm going to move your finger up and down, and you tell me if I'm going up or down, okay?
Okay. Up.
Yes.
Down. Up. Up. Down.
Very good. Okay. So position sense is intact. All right. Now we're going to take test his stereognosis. And I'm going to put an object in your hand, Jay, and I want you to try to feel of it and tell me what you think it is. So close your eyes. Okay. All right. Feel of that.
It's a key.
It's a key. Very good. It's your key. All right. So that's good. The patient identifies the key. No problem. All right, and keep your eyes closed still. What I'm gonna have you do is reach up and put your arms out and reach up and touch your nose on both sides. Very good. All right, so cerebellar function is intact there. And we did the heel to shin while he was still laying down and that was intact. So we're good there. All right, and now I'm going to test his deep tendon reflexes. Make sure you can see me. Okay. So I'm going to, I don't have a reflux hammer, so I'm going to simulate it with a big spoon. And I'm going to tap here. Good. And I'm going to test the biceps, the triceps. Good. The brachio radialis, good. The patellar, good. And the Achilles, good. All intact. All right, and then I'm just gonna do the Babinski. Let me see your foot. Very good. All right. Negative. All right, and lastly, we're gonna do the musculoskeletal. So Jay, if you'll stand up and just stand right here for me. We don't have a lot of space, but we're gonna work with what we have. And I'm gonna have him walk across the room towards me. Okay, very good. Now I want you to walk back, heel to toe. Normal gait and station. And I'm going to have you now walk on your tiptoes back to me. Normal gait and station. And now walk on your heels back. Very good. Normal gait and station. Now I'm going to check his Romberg sign. If you just come stand here, let me see. You're very, very tall. So your head's going to be cut off, but that's okay. And just stand like this. Now close your eyes. All right, very good. So I'm not seeing any swaying or loss of balance here. So very good. You pass the Romberg, no loss of balance, no swing. And what I'm going to have you do now is a shallow knee bend. Do it like that. Both sides. Very good. Cerebellar function intact here as well. And last but not least, I'm going to have you just take your range of motion on your spine. So lean forward. Touch your toes. Very good. Wish I could do that. All right, come up and lean back. Very good. And left to right. Very nice. Very nice. And normal gait and station here as well. And if you'll have a seat, Jay, thank you so very much. I appreciate your time today. Any questions for me?
No, I don't.
All right. I appreciate your time. Thank you so much.